coming back to office markets, our general stock till 2006 was 100 million square feet in top 7 cities. It took us 6 years, including DLF, Unitec, Prestige, other very large developers putting grade A asset to build the first 100 million square feet. Look at what happens after that. Every 7 to 9 to 7 quarters, we are putting another 100, we are putting another 100, we are putting another 100. It's amazing how we are able to pour this much concrete. You can see that on an average, we are putting 100 million square feet of new office supply in 7 quarters. That is roughly, putting 7 development points a year in different parts of the city, in different parts of the country. That's how much office stock is getting added. This is a very interesting slide. It gives you data on how this office is getting added. If you notice, 2005, 6, and 7 were almost a honeymoon period for Indian real estate. The red bar shows how much new supply we were putting up. The gray bar shows how much was the absorption. So every single square inch that the developer was building in 2005, 6 and 7, he was able to lease out. He was extremely happy. He thought world is going to go up. This is going to be great. He starts to build much more at a much faster pace. So in 2008, we put 42 million square feet. And suddenly the demand is over 33. So we start seeing vacancy building up. 2009, of course, was a debacle with the global financial crisis. We put in about 42 million square feet. And you only leased out half. So the demand just fell off. Suddenly corporates were not coming in, America was under stress. Clients started to sort of back off to say, let's wait and watch what's going on. And we built, and every time in 2009, one in every two buildings was vacant. So that is how much vacancy was building up. 2010, again, demand starts to pick up, things are better, we are more resilient than we thought we were, and very quickly we go up to 30 million square feet again in demand, but you know what, buildings are being built, you can't shell them, and still put in 40 million. So if you continue to add like this, this year has been phenomenal, and we follow calendar year, so it's easy to understand. January to December, we put 35 million square feet estimated, which is almost double from 2009. So your demand has gone up twice, yet the unfortunate part is that your office buildings are going up faster. So you're putting and adding more supply. So you have one road in Bombay called the Lower Parel area, Senapati Bapun. There are 6 buildings of 1 million square feet. That's 2 times the size of Nariman Point. Nariman Point took 10 years to build, another 15 years to lease out. It went through one recession to come out of it and lease out. Now you're adding one building which is 1 million square feet, and there are 6 of them come up there, and we think that it's going to get leased in 2 years. I guess you don't need JLL, you need somebody else to try and fill those up. So it's really the quantum and the scale of projects that have changed. People have to comprehend that you know, you're building a building which is like 6 buildings of Nariman Point put together, that's one project. So really it is quite unique. So there was another project which I think most of you guys would be quite associated with, which is the Diamond Boats project in BKC. That's 3.5 million square feet. That's 2 times the size of Nariman Point. Just one complex is that large. And for it to become operational, occupied, you know, obviously is no joke. It is going to take its own natural course to get leased out. So really this is the scenario. We think the office markets are very good. What's happened in office is that if you haven't broken ground, you've shelved the project. So if you were looking at the 2009 graph or 8 graph, which is saying 42 million square feet, when we were doing our homework, actually this graph was like 90 million square feet. Suddenly our developers are very agile, they are very flexible, they realized office is going to be under pain, they started shifting it to residential, retail, whatever other asset class, they could, wherever they could. What you are seeing on this red bar is something that can't be moved. So you're on the 10th floor of an office building, which is a 12th floor building. You're obviously not going to stop it. It's better to finish that building and then wait for somebody to come in. So this supply is almost mandatory.